The fear now is that the gap is closing rapidly.
Well, with me now is Brett Carr, a senior lecturer in psychotherapy at Regent's College London, who specialises in adolescent offenders. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
So why is this happening then? Why are girls catching up with boys?
Well, I think the first thing we have to ask is this really true, that there is an increase in girl gangs? I think if you study the history of criminology, you'll find that women have been committing violent crimes since time immemorial.
Oh, so it's not getting any worse? Just ruin our story.
Well, I think it's difficult to ascertain. I think if you ask any psychologist or criminologist, they'll tell you that there's a real difference between the actual rate of crimes being committed and our ability to better identify these crimes. And I think we are actually getting much better at realising that young girls do have the capacity to perpetrate quite violent crimes.
So you don't think this is anything to do with girl power, the rise of girl power, the empowerment of the ladette culture, if you like?
Well, I don't think we can blame it on the Spice Girls, if that's what you mean. But I do think that it is possible that there is a slight rise in girl crime, crime committed by young girls. I think particularly as we're witnessing more and more the equality between the sexes. And I think now young girls are feeling that they can identify with young boys, not only in healthy aspects, but also in violent and destructive aspects as well.
And perhaps different parenting, because in the past, you know, that there probably was a tendency perhaps for parents to treat girls differently from boys.
I think that's certainly a possibility that we have to examine, yes indeed.
So, I mean, do you think this trend will actually develop? Do you think we are actually going to really see a rise in girl gangs and vicious girl gangs?
I do hope not, because certainly, as your report has shown, it's very devastating for the residents who find themselves victimised by these girl gangs, and if they're carrying knives and other weapons, they can be quite dangerous indeed.
Now, is it something that girls grow out of and that boys continue in, if you like?
I think we're just really now for the first time studying girl crime quite seriously, and I think it's too early really to tell what the longitudinal outcome is going to be.
And what about social, where the girl gangs actually happen? Is it only a city trend?
I think it very much congregates in cities, but I think what we need to try to understand first is some of the motivations why these girls might participate in gang formations of this kind. And I think what you find is that when young children, particularly young adolescents, find themselves drawn into gangs, there is often a problem with identity. And I think the attraction of something called a gang is a way of trying to find other people who can help to give you an identity.
Brett Carr, thank you very much for talking to us this morning.
Thank you.
OK, it's 17 minutes to 7. In a moment, the news, weather and travel, where you are.
Still to come on the News Hour on GMTV, what are you planning to do this weekend? Stay with us because we have some ideas which might surprise you. Find out more at 10.
95.